strong. Now there is power to move on.
Ezekiel chapter 13, verses 1 through 16. Amen. The title of today's message is Standing on the Promises of God. Standing on the promises of God. The Word of God is our foundation. It's what we should be deeply rooted in. It is the truth upon which we stand. It is the truth that grounds and orders our lives. So though the storms may come, though the tests may come, though the trials may come, though the lies of the enemy may come, though the doubts and the fears may come, we reject all of that. And we just continue to stand on God's word, standing on what God has said, standing on his truth, standing on his promises. Amen. Ezekiel chapter 13, verses 1 through 16. Everybody there? Let's read God's word together. The Lord spoke his word to me, saying, human, prophesy against the prophets of Israel. Say to those who make up their own prophecies, listen to the word of the Lord. This is what the Lord God says. How terrible it will be for the foolish prophets who follow their own ideas and have not seen a vision from me. People of Israel, your prophets have been like wild dogs hunting to kill and eat among ruins. Israel is like a house in ruins, but you have not gone up into the broken places or repaired the wall. So how can Israel hold back the enemy in the battle on the Lord's day of judging? Your prophets see false visions and prophesy lies. They say, this is the message of the Lord, when the Lord has not sent them. But they still hope their words will come true. You said, this is the message of the Lord, but that is a false vision. Your prophecies are lies because I have not spoken. So this is what the Lord God says. Because you prophets spoke things that are false and saw visions that do not come true, I am against you, says the Lord God. I will punish the prophets who see false visions and prophesy lies. They will have no place among my people. Their names will not be written on the list of the people of Israel, and they will not enter the land of Israel. Then you will know that I am the Lord God. It is because they lead my people the wrong way by saying peace when there is no peace. When the people build a weak wall, the prophets cover it with whitewash to make it look strong. So tell those who cover a weak wall with whitewash that it will fall down. Rain will pour down, hailstones will fall, and a stormy wind will break the wall down. When the wall has fallen, people will ask you, where is the whitewash you used on the wall? So this is what the Lord God says. I will break the wall with a stormy wind. In my anger, rain will pour down, and hailstones will destroy the wall. I will tear down the wall on which you put whitewash. I will level it to the ground so that people will see the wall's foundation. And when the wall falls, you will be destroyed under it. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So I will carry out my anger on the wall and against those who covered it with whitewash. Then I will tell you, the wall is gone, and those who covered it with whitewash are gone. The prophets of Israel who prophesy to Jerusalem and who see visions of peace for the city when there is no peace will be gone, says the Lord God. This is the word of God for the people of God. Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord, for your word. We thank you, Lord, for your teaching, for your mighty truth, Lord. This is the foundation, Lord, upon which our lives are rooted in. This is the instruction manual for our lives, the guide, Lord, our rules, the order of which we live by, your kingdom governing laws, oh God. So, Lord God, we just ask that you would open up this word to us, Lord, that you would teach, that you would instruct, that you would pour out a fresh word on your people today, Lord, a word that we need, and that this word will be hidden deeply in our hearts, Lord. Give us revelation, Lord. Give us knowledge. Give us wisdom. Give us understanding as only you can do. Help us to apply this word to our very lives from this moment forward and to live by all of your truth in your word forever and ever, and to reject every lie of the enemy, to reject anything that is not from you, Lord, because we are live and move and have our being in you, God, and there is no other, Lord. So, Lord God, we thank you and we praise your name today. Lord, I ask you would take all of the me out of this message. Let it be solely, Lord, for your glory, Lord, and for the building up of the people of your church, that we all might be more and more like your son, Jesus, that we would walk like him, talk like him, think like him, have faith like him, move like him, and have our being like him, Lord, in this very present world today, until you come again, Lord Jesus. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen. I'm standing on the promises of God. Here God speaks a strong conviction and punishment against all of these false prophets, all of these false teachers who have been lying to the people, who have been telling them things that were not from God. And he's saying, telling them, your word will not stand. You've been praying on my people, praying P-R-E-Y. Not P-R-A-Y, P-R-E-Y. Too many false prophets have been praying on the people instead of praying P-R-A-Y for the people. So here it is. God is sending a word of conviction, a word of punishment, a word saying, I see what you're doing in my house. I see the lies. I see the false truths. I see the fakeness and the phoniness. I see the fake visions. This is not a word from me. And the words you have spoken shall fall. The word you have spoken shall fall down and be revealed before all that you have lied on my people, and it will lead to your destruction. All the pretty whitewash that you covered. Whitewash is what you use to paint a fence. If you have a fence that's old and raggedy looking, but you don't have the money to replace it, people would take whitewash and just paint over it to make it look better. Now the fence is still raggedy. The fence is still falling down, broken down. The wood on the fence is still rotten, but they paint whitewash over it so that you can't see that the wood is rotten. And here God is saying that these false prophets have been teaching these people lies, have been leading them in the wrong way, have been speaking a word that is not from him. And he's saying, I see your whitewash. And so not only am I going to reveal the whitewash, not only am I going to reveal the shadiness of the walls you have built, the incompleteness, the lack of strength in the walls you have put up, but I'm going to make that wall crumble so that people can see the foundation. The foundation of our lives is the Word of God and Jesus Christ, who is the Word made flesh. That is why he is called the chief cornerstone. He is the foundation of our faith. And because he is the Word made flesh, this Word is also the foundation of our faith. You can't build anything on shaky ground. You can't build anything on a rotten foundation. You can't build anything if the foundation is cracked and messed up and beat up and marred and unlevel. You need solid ground in order to build your house on. You need a solid foundation in order to be able to stand. You need a solid word, and it has to be the word of the Lord, because only the word of the Lord is solid. Everything else is sinking sand. Everything else is miry clay. Everything else is something you'll sink in and won't be able to get a foothold on. You can only stand solid on the word of God. Everything else is shaky. Everything else, you'll lose your balance. The enemy wants people in the church to lose their balance. And one of the biggest ways he does it is by speaking his lies so that they will build their lives on a foundation that is not solid. So many people, their lives are consumed with fear. That is not the word of God. The word of God says God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. Fear is a spirit. Fear is a spirit that combats faith, which is also a spirit. We, the just, choose to live by faith. We, God's children, choose to live by faith. We, kingdom heirs, heirs of God, and joint heir with Christ, live by faith because it was our faith in Jesus Christ, acknowledging him as Lord and Savior of the world, that made us kingdom ambassadors, that made us heirs of God and joined with Christ, believing that Jesus came and saved us and died for us. That is the foundation of our faith, and we must stand on the solid rock, Christ Jesus. We must stand on what is firm. We can't afford to lose our balance. The enemy comes around trying to get God's children to teeter-totter, to try to waver like this so that they shaking, because he wants to see you fall. He wants to see you stumble. He wants you to hit your head on the ground so that then he can come over and torment you and do whatever he wants to do with you. But somebody ought to say, no, I'm standing on God's word. I'm not shaking. I'm not wavering. I'm not moving from my faith confession. I'm not moving from the word of God. I'm not moving from the promises God has given me. I don't care what God has told you, what he has promised you. I'm a witness. He can do it and he will do it. Don't you waver. Don't you waver. Don't you listen to the lies of the enemy saying, you can't have that. You ain't never going to get that. You ain't never going to be that. Your body going to hurt all your life. You going to have this pain in your knee for the next 30 years. That's a lie from the pit of hell. Everything that is in the word of God, I believe. And everything that is not in the word of God, I 100% reject in the name of Jesus. It's on us. Don't lose your balance by standing on something that's not firm. Don't lose your balance by even taking one foot. See, you can lose your balance so quick, just like that. And that's what the enemy wants. We know the word of God. We know the promises of God. We know God says we're healed. We know that. We all know by Jesus' stripes we are healed. We're already healed. We all know that. We all already know that he will never leave us nor forsake us, and that we are never alone, but that he is always with us. We all know that. We all know that Jehovah Jireh is the Lord, our provider, that our God shall supply all our needs according to his glorious riches in Christ Jesus. We all know that. We all know the word of God. But the enemy wants you to stand on the sand for just a minute. Just a second long enough for you to lose your balance and fall. He wants you to step out on doubt. He wants you to step out on fear. He wants you to step out on unbelief, because he knows the minute you step out, you start sinking. It's just like Peter on the water. Peter walking on the water. Jesus say, come. He had Peter coming. Then he started looking at waves. At a blusterous wind, it says, he looked at the great wind. He started to doubt. And he immediately started sinking. That's what the word of God says. You cannot stand on something that's not solid. Doubt will never hold you up. You won't make it through. I'll tell you right now, you won't make it through with doubt. You won't make it through with worry. You won't make it through with unbelief. You won't make it through with despair. You won't make it through with depression. You won't make it through with anxiety. And God knows you won't make it through. That's why he said, be anxious for nothing. But in everything, with prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, make your requests known to God. He knows you won't make it through. God knows the tricks of the enemy before the enemy can come up with one. God already knows them all. God is omnipotent. The devil is not. God knows everything that the devil has planned, that the devil has thought of, that the devil can even dream of. God already knows it all. And he has already given us every battle strategy we need to defeat the devil every time. I was continuing to watch my CDs from Bill Winston came, and I watched them all this week. I'm watching them all again this week because it was a good teaching on faith. Amen. And one thing he was saying is that faith is called the good fight of faith. And it's called the good fight of faith because faith wins every time. Faith is victorious every time. It's a good fight. It's not a losing fight. It's not a shaky fight. It's not a, oh, I don't know how it's going to turn out fight. No, it's a good fight because faith wins every single time. The enemy has nothing to combat faith. Nothing. There's nothing he can do. All he has are lies and deception and trickery. That's all he has. He's smoke and mirrors. That's all he has. If he can make you doubt, if he can make you worry, if he can make you give in to unbelief, he knows you will automatically start sinking. Because faith holds you up. Faith in the word of God is what holds you up. That's your solid foundation. Believing God's word. And believing the very person of Jesus Christ that he is who he said he is. And he did all he came to do and finished it completely. That is what we stand on. But the devil's just looking for an opportunity, just a moment, of somebody to give in the word. It only took a second for Peter to start sinking. He was walking on top of the water just like Jesus. Just as he had asked Jesus, could he do? And Jesus said, come. And here he is walking on the water. But in a split second, he started looking at the wind. He started looking at the storm. He started looking at the sea. He started doubting that he could walk on the water. Even though he was already doing it, he started doubting. And immediately, he says he started sinking. So then he cried out, Lord, save me. And it says Jesus reached out a hand and caught him. Now, God is faithful. When we stumble, when we fall, he'll catch us. He'll pick us up. He'll dust us off. He'll restore us. He'll help us to get our balance again. But we have to grow up. We have to grow strong in our faith. Parents catch their one-year-olds when they're learning how to walk all the time. They'll pick them up 20 times a day. Come on, baby, it's okay. Pick you up. Let's try again. They'll hold hands. Let's take another step. But then there's a day that comes where that baby finds their balance. And then from that day forward, they start running, and they don't never look back. Then you don't have to pick them up anymore. They run, and you can't catch them. That's the way we need to be in our faith, where we are running. So strong. We can't afford to step out on something that's unshaky. God, I say God all the time, train me for battle. Train me for battle, God. And he is so faithful to do just that. He has given me discernment of spirits the minute they come. The minute they come, this is a spirit of anger. Cast it out. This is a spirit of bitterness. Cast it out. This is a spirit of rebellion. Cast it out. This is fear. Cast it out. I was in my house this week, and the TV downstairs came on by itself. So what did the devil say? Somebody's in your house. So then I start looking around and I start praying. And then I said, nobody in this house with me, and me with me, in this house with me, but Jesus and the angels he sends. I said, anything that's not Jesus or the angels he sends, you get out right now. And immediately the spirit, but I recognize it's a spirit of fear. I said, you can't stay here. I had just made my confession that day that I will have zero fear in my life anymore. God has not given me fear. I don't want it. I reject it every time. I just made that confession, and no sooner than you make it, but an hour later, the devil will try to do something to make you go back on that confession. But we have the word of God. We can recognize and discern the tricks and the tactics of the enemy and not fall for them. We don't have to give in to fear. We don't have to give in to worry. We don't have to give in to stress. We don't have to give in to strife. We don't have to give in to any of his lies. And not only do we not have to give in to it, but God expects us to reject those lies. He says, let God be true. Let God be true and every man a lie. He says clearly, I am the one who is true. I am your truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He is the truth upon which we stand. God expects us by now. We've been in church too long. We've been reading the word too long to not by now have grown enough to reject the lies of the enemy the minute they come. Isn't that what Jesus did? The minute the enemy came tempting him, he rejected them every time. And he rejected them with what? The word of God. It is written. It is written. It is written was his response. We stand on the word. That's how our house is built and will stand. The word of God says clearly, unless the Lord builds a house, it won't stand. The Lord builds houses on what? Solid rock. Christ Jesus, the word made flesh. He builds houses on his word and on Jesus Christ, the word made flesh. And they stand. Anything that is rooted in the word of God will stand. It has to. That's why when Jesus cursed the fig tree, that tree had to die. It had to. It couldn't stay. Because the word of the Lord said, you are cursed. It had to dry up, and the word says it dried up from the root. It is the same thing with us. The word of God is so powerful, And people don't realize just how powerful it is. As I was praying and meditating this week, God said, my word is so powerful it can be sent as like an atomic bomb to destroy the enemy. In World War II, what really ended the war was the development of the atomic bomb and the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, those two cities in Japan. Because that technology completely defeated the enemy's technology of guns and everything they had, troops on the ground. You don't have to fight face-to-face combat. Send the word of God and watch the enemy run. So many Christians think you have to fight toe-to-toe with the devil like this, like it's an even fight. It's not an even fight. It is not, and it will never be an even fight, because the word of God within you is always greater than any lie he can come up with. It is not an even fight. It's not I hit you and you hit me back and I try to hit you a little bit harder and then you knock me down. Then I get up and really jump on you. No, I'm going to send the word of God and blow you to smithereens right now. He said, my word is like an atomic bomb. You can send it and blow up every enemy and completely refute any attack of the enemy. That's why that man who believed, he sent the word of healing to his servant. And because of his faith, his servant was healed that very hour, and that's what Jesus told him. This is what also God said. He said, my word is like an atomic bomb. Your faith is the detonator. You can have a huge, powerful bomb. I'm talking about C4. I'm talking about big stacks of dynamite. But if you don't detonate it, if you don't send it off, it's not going to do anything. But when you push the button, see, too many Christians are standing like this. They got the faith. They have it in their hand, but they're wavering. So their fingers like this on the button. Instead of just pushing it and saying, I'm standing on this faith. Devil, every attack you've made against my household, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. Every attack you've made against my body, every lie from the pit of hell that you've told, I cancel it in the authority in the name of Jesus Christ. You have no power. That's how we put it. And then you rest on it. If somebody had a bomb and they detonated, they're not going to run to see if the bomb worked. They're going to get away because they know the bomb worked. Too many people, they waver on their faith where they don't push the button. They don't detonate the mighty word of God. Or they start to push it, and then they back up on it. Or they start to push it, and then are trying to run towards it to see if it worked. Real faith rests. When Jesus, after it has made his decree, it rests. When I say rest, I mean assurance. I mean 100% confident that it is going to happen just as you have spoken it. Real faith will rest. When Jesus cursed that fig tree, he didn't stand there beside the tree and watch it to see when it was going to die and how it was going to die and how it was going to shrivel up and how the roots. No, he was on a journey. He had somewhere to go. He was going to minister. He kept going. He said, I curse you. Never shall you bear fruit again. And then he kept going. Then he went and did what he had to do. And on the way back, Jesus didn't even stop. He knew the tree was dead. The disciples stopped him and said, Lord, look. Here is the tree that you cursed. Look, Lord, it's withered from the root. Now notice the disciples stopped and were amazed. Jesus didn't stop until they stopped him, and Jesus was not amazed because he knew that from the moment he said, never shall you bear fruit again, that tree was never going to put out another fig, nothing, ever again. Real faith rests on the word of God. It has that assurance. It has that confidence. As Bill Winston was teaching, he kept saying, stop looking to see proof. Stop looking to see proof. That's living by sight. We don't live by sight. We live by faith. Stop looking to see proof. Faith says, I know it is because I just know. I don't need to see proof. I don't need evidence. My faith is the evidence. My faith is the substance. My faith is the proof. So when you speak those decrees that line up with God's word, it must line up with God's word. It must be in alignment with his word. It must be in alignment with his will. But when you speak those decrees, when you make your faith confessions, when you receive a promise from the Lord, something he has spoken to you or something he has given you through his word, stand on it and rest. Stand on it and be assured, because you just know God is not capable of lying. He's not capable of it. He has never told a lie, and he never will tell a lie, because he is not capable of it. So there is nothing God has promised you that you will not get 100%, because God is not capable of lying. Now, the enemy, that's all he does. That's all he does. And the Bible tells us that. It tells us very clearly the truth is not in him. So it's on us. Push the button. Push the faith button. The word of God. He says, prove me in this and see if I will not open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. That was in response to God's instructions to bring the tithes and offerings into the storehouse. He says, prove me in this and see. He says, basically saying, I know what I promised you and I know I'm going to do it. So you just need to believe me. And wait expectantly and see how I bless you. See how I do it. See how I perform it. Stop worrying over when this going to happen. When that going to happen. I tell myself that too. Stop worrying over that. Jesus did not stand and look at that fig tree to see it exactly what second it would die. If it died 1 second, a half a second, a millisecond, or 3 seconds after he said, he did not stand there. He cursed it and kept moving. And when he came back, he knew it was dead. And he wasn't amazed. The disciples stopped him and said, Lord, look. Real faith rests on the word of God. It's too much anxiety, too much back and forth, too much, Lord, I want to believe you and I'm trying to believe you, but there is no but with God. Lord, I believe you, period. End of sentence. That's why I love to hear Auntie Irma say, I believe God's word, because she puts a big period right there. You can hear when she said, I believe God's word, period. It's on us to say, I'm standing on it, and I reject every lie. There will be many lies from the enemy, and he will use many people to try to lie. Many false prophets, false teachers. That's why you must know the word of God for yourself. That's why you must study yourself. I see too many Bibles left here week after week that have people's names in it. Take your Bible home. You need it every day. Every day you need it. I was so encouraged to hear Kayla's testimony, because I love to see all of us growing, and especially these young people growing, when she says, I read my Bible every day, and when I didn't, I just didn't feel right. Because if you don't read God's word, your spirit is starving. Just like your body won't feel right. If you go the whole day or 2 days or 3 days without food, your body feels weak when you go without natural food. Your spirit is weak when you go without the word of God. That is your nourishment. That is why when Jesus went by himself to pray and to meditate on God's word, he said, when the disciples came back and they said, Master, have you eaten? Have you any food? He said, I have food. And they're looking around, looking to see if they see some bread or some fish or something. He's like, what is he talking about? Did anybody bring him some food? And everybody's like, no, we didn't bring him any food. We don't see any food. What are you talking about, Master? And he said, my food is the word. My food is to do the will of him who sent me. He was talking about how important it is to feed your spirit. What did Jesus command Peter? He said, if you really love me, he asked him, do you love me? Peter said, yes, Lord, yes, you know I love you. He said, feed my sheep. What are the sheep fed? They not fed grass. The sheep are fed the word of God. That's what we feed on. That's what Jesus was instructing Peter to do after he was gone. If you love me, feed my sheep, because they need my word as their nourishment. It's the foundation upon which they stand, and they won't have the strength to fight the enemy. You can't fight the enemy if you don't have any strength, and you won't have any strength if you don't have the word of God in you. You can't just have a Bible in your hand and go toe-to-toe with the devil. You must have it in your heart. Then you blow him up. It's on us. He says very clearly in this word. He said, the prophets have been preying on my people like wild dogs, hunting to kill and eat among ruins. And we know that they're being used by the devil, because the devil is the one who comes to kill, steal, and destroy. So anybody that's preying on God's people, trying to destroy them, they're being used by the devil. But here he says, these false visions, these lies, these things that I have not spoken, God says, I'm against you. He says, those weak walls that you covered up with lies and prophecy and false prophecy and messages that people want to hear. See, there's a whole lot of preachers that only tell people what they want to hear. Those who are sent by God and who live for God will tell them whatever God says, whether you like it or not. It's on us to say, God, I reject every lie. I reject every attack of the enemy. I reject everything that does not line up with your word. And everything that you have promised me, I receive it now. The word of God says clearly, it says, when you pray, believe you have received it, and then you shall have it. That's what the word says. When you pray, believe you already got it. The house is mine. The husband is mine. The job is mine. Peace in my family is mine. A good and faithful marriage is mine. Believe healing is mine. Believe you have it. That's what the spirit of faith says. I already got it. I don't need to wait to see when it's coming. I already got it. That's why Jesus didn't need to wait to see, was the tree going to die and shrivel up, and how long was it going to take the tree to die and shrivel up? Like, I already got it. That tree is dead. Let's go on minister to these people. It's on us to say, I'm standing on your word, God. I will not be moved from it. I'm standing on what's solid. You cannot stand on something shaky. On something shaky, you always going to be wavering, fighting to keep your balance. And when you can't keep your balance anymore, you fall. But when you stand on what is solid, on what is unmoving, what is unshakable, then you can stand just like this. I'm not going anywhere. I tell the devil that all the time. I'm not going anywhere. You're going to run from me every day of your life. I don't have to run from you. I don't have to be scared of you. I don't have to worry about nothing you can do, because it's not a fair fight. It's a good fight. It's the good fight of faith. And through faith in Christ Jesus, we are victorious every time. As I close this word, I just want to leave you with one thing to remember from Ephesians chapter 6. I have been meditating a lot on the whole armor of God, because my prayer every day has been, God, train me for battle. God, train me for battle. So every day I meditate and wear the full armor of God, and God trains me for battle. It says, Ephesians chapter 6, starting at verse 10, finally be strong in the Lord and in his great power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can fight against the devil's evil tricks. Our fight is not against people on earth, but against the rulers and authorities and powers of this world's darkness, against the spiritual powers of evil in the heavenly world. That is why you need to put on God's full armor. Then on the day of evil, you will be able to stand strong. And when you have finished the whole fight, you will still be standing. Now, I'm going to finish reading that in a minute, but I want to give you guys a little bit of insight. Now, this armor that they talk about, the shield and the breastplate of righteousness and the shoes and all of these different things, all the different parts, the belt, all the different parts in the armor of God, they were compared. Remember, Jesus always taught in parables, and this is Paul speaking, but he also was helping to use this parable, this analogy, to help people relate. They were talking about the Roman armor. soldier's army. This is the same kind of garb that the Roman soldiers wear. Have a big shield, have a big breastplate, have big belt, have big stuff on their feet. It was a full armor, have a big helmet. And so he wanted to let them know in this way that God's tools, God's resources, God's armor is just like this. It will cover you from head to toe, and it will completely protect you from every attack of the enemy. And so in the same way, we want to be completely covered. That's what faith says. Faith says, I'm completely covered everywhere I go. I'm covered under the blood of Jesus. The angels of goodness and mercy follow after me all the days of my life. The glory of the Lord is at my back because I trust in him. We know that we are completely covered, that even if a host encamp around us, it doesn't matter. Nothing matters. We know that we are completely covered by God's word and by everything that God has said and by this armor that God has told us to wear. Now, the Roman soldiers were known for being extremely cruel and brutal in their fighting. This is historical knowledge. Extremely cruel, extremely brutal in their fighting. And so when they would fight, it was always to the death. Remember, the Romans were one of the first nations that had like Olympics. Like they had like these Olympic type games in Rome. And big famous people would come from all around to see these like Olympic type games. And the games were very, very brutal and very, very violent. And the person who won was always standing, and their opponent was at their feet dead. Completely mangled, completely destroyed, bloody, a hot mess, totally messed up. So get this in your mind, what it means to stand on God's word. Because too often people read it as stand like, oh, I'm just waiting for God to move. I'm just standing here. No, it is a stance of victory. It is the victor who is left standing. In the battle, the opponent is completely defeated and dead and mangled and tore up. So when you get in your mind of how it's going to be, when you make your faith decree of how it's going to turn out, because remember, faith always decrees the outcome before you even go into battle. That was part of Bill Winston's teaching. It was excellent. I'm going to bring that teaching so y'all can watch it. But anyway, keep in mind that the stand, it's not like a passive stand like, oh, I'm just waiting. It's a stance of the victor. That's why it's the good fight of faith. Because we are victorious every time through Christ Jesus. Jesus told me I already conquered this world. In this world, you will have many tribulations. But be of what? Good cheer. Faith always keeps a good attitude. Because faith believes God for the best and believes God to work it out 100%. Faith believes no matter how it looks right here, God is still working it out for your good. Faith believes like Joseph, what the enemy meant for bad, God means it for my good. So, devil, you really going to end up working in my favor, and you just too stupid to even realize it. It's on us to keep that in our mindset, that when we stand on the word of God, it's a victory stand. It's a victory position to be upright. And who's at our feet? The enemy. Isn't that what the word God said? That I will make your enemies your footstool under my feet, devil. That's where you belong. That's where you stay. But we stand on the word of God, and it's the position of victory. You've seen those like commercials, those corny commercials, and they sing that song, we are the champions, we are the champions. And then you see somebody like standing real victorious, like they're a winner, like they're a champion prize fighter or something. That's our idea of how we stand on the word of God. Too many people, oh, well, I'm just praying. I'm just hoping God will work it out. I'm just believing. No, don't say it like that. Jesus said, be of what? Good cheer. Be excited. Be excited. I'm so excited. I'm so excited about what God is doing in my life right now. I'm so excited about this church. I'm so excited about my husband. I'm so excited about my children. I'm so excited about all of the visions he has given me of magazines and businesses and community centers for youth and campuses for youth, because somebody going to raise these children and teach them about Jesus. I'm tired of seeing these children, and nobody has taught them anything about God. They didn't taught them everything that's wrong. Taught them how to get high. Taught them how to get pregnant. Taught them how to to find baby daddies. Literally, I had a five-year-old who in front of me told another little boy, you're going to be my baby daddy. Yeah, my mama got two baby daddies. That's what she said. I'm going to have one too at five. So, yes, I'm excited. And I don't need to see it here. I know it here. And we all must be the same way. We don't need to see it. I pray all the time, Lord, I refuse to be like Thomas. I don't want to have to put my hands in your nail prints in your hands. And if you think about it, if you think about how wondrous the gospel is, if we can truly believe God's word, that the Lord God Jehovah, creator of heavens and earth, came to this earth in the form of a man, was born as a newborn baby, conceived by the Holy Spirit to a virgin woman. If we can believe that, and that's, we all know, would be impossible outside of God, but with God it was possible. If we can believe that, how can we not believe God to touch our bodies, to bless our finances, to unite our family, to grow our church? It just doesn't make sense. You either operate in faith or you don't. If you can truly believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, born of a virgin, you can believe anything. You can believe God for anything. If you truly believe the great God Jehovah created this world in 6 days and everything in it, you can believe God for anything. It doesn't make sense that we say, yes, Jesus is Lord, and yes, God made the sun and the moons and the stars, but then we don't believe God can get me another job. That doesn't make sense. We either operate in faith or we don't. But the good fight of faith, it's a continual fight. That's why the word says that we live by faith. And I thank God, because it's exciting to me to be able to use my faith. It's like Christmas every morning. To get up and use my faith, to get up and make decrees, and to watch all the different ways that God channels his power through my faith. It's amazing. It was amazing. I just looked at that class in wonder when all the kids were like that. I was like, God, you're so amazing, God, of how quickly you answered that prayer and how you just made it so evident and so clear that it was you, God. It's on us. It's on us to believe God's word and say, God, you are true, God. And I reject everything that is a lie, that is not from you. I reject everything that is not yours. I was asking God for revelation on his word and revelation regarding my husband. And he said, you are already a bride. He said, my word is better than any engagement ring. He said, an engagement ring comes from a man and it's a promise that he can go back on. My word is true. It's on us. And I believe that. And I just said, oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for that wonderful revelation of helping me to understand that I don't need to see him coming here before I already know that I got him. We shouldn't need to see it. If we need to see it, it's not faith. Faith just knows it. So we're going to stand on God's promises. We're going to stand not in a passive stand like, oh, I'm just standing here waiting to see what God will do. No, stand in the victory stance that you have. Stand knowing the enemy is under your feet. Stand knowing that every lie has been refuted and has been sitting back to the pit of hell from the moment you spoke the word of God. Stand strong in that and say, thank you, Jesus, for making me a champion. Thank you, Jesus, for completing 100% victory through you. Thank you, Jesus, for the faith to believe and that your power is channeled through it. Thank you, Lord, for giving me the belief. Thank you, Lord, for letting me see the outcome here before it happens here. That's the good fight we fight. That's how we stand on God's promises. I just want to close with finishing reading this whole armor of God. Then on the day of evil, you will be able to stand strong. And when you have finished the whole fight, you will still be standing. So stand strong with the belt of truth tied around your waist and the protection of right living on your chest. On your feet, wear the good news of peace to help you stand strong. And also use the shield of faith, which with you can stop all the burning arrows of the evil one. Accept God's salvation as your helmet and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. Pray in the Spirit at all times with all kinds of prayer, asking for everything you need. To do this, you must always be ready and never give up, and always pray for all God's people. Amen. That's how we stand strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, covered completely from head to toe. Notice God didn't leave anybody parts out. He covered the head all the way down to the feet. We are completely covered in God's army, and there is no room for the enemy to penetrate at all. But it says with the shield of faith, you can stop all the fiery darts, every last one, every attack. There's nothing the devil can come up with that can beat you as long as you stand on God's word and do what he told you to do. Nothing. He's a loser every time. Who's the biggest loser for real? The devil. He's the biggest loser. I tell him that. You're the biggest loser. I tell him all the time, you need to go get you some water, because you're not going to have none at 123 Eternal Burning Lane. So you better get you some while you can. But God is just putting my
mind. Now we are never alone. Your blood and makes us strong. Now there is power.